This morning in the Rhode Show kitchen, we have Chef Bob Burke from Pots of Feu, and we are making a lovely French dish today. We are making
Bouillabaisse.
Bouillabaisse, which is?
It's a French fish stew, but don't think stew in the way most people do, that you cook the fish to death.
Okay.
Today we're going to do something that's more like a poaching liquid.
Okay, we just want to be a little lighter.
We want to cook the fish just as much as we would cook it if we were grilling it or, you know, sauteing it. Mm-hmm. So we don't want to overkill it.
We still have that nice light flaky texture.
Exactly.
To it.
That's what we're going for with the bouillabaisse. And it's from the Mediterranean. It's the city of Marseille, which is kind of this really rough, you know, been around for centuries kind of fish town. Mm-hmm. And it's really a neat place, but it's robust. The flavors are really robust.
You talked about the flavors. What do we need here?
Well, some really cool stuff. The first of all is our fennel bulb. Mm-hmm. And give that a sniff and tell me what you think. It's kind of a licorice-y.
Yeah, it smells like black licorice.
Yeah, yeah. And this is great. We're going to julienne that.
Okay.
And then, of course, garlic. You're looking for a robust flavor in a fish soup. You got to get garlic in there. A little paprika. A touch of cayenne pepper, and then over here, the most expensive food that you can probably come across, about $840 a pound right now.
What?
Yep, pick it up, smell it. It's saffron, and these are
fragrant.
They pick the pistils right out of the flowers. So it's hugely labor intensive to go out and pick these out.
Must be why they cost so much.
And it's a beautiful flavor. Mm-hmm. So those are the really distinctive flavors. And of course, we've got some onion and tomato that's going to go into it.
Yep.
Some great local seafood.
Okay.
And we're going to make a really nice summer dish today.
Nice. A good summer dish, a good summer French dish. And we'll show you the seafood coming up a little later in the show. It's great. Go Providence has brought us Chef Bob Burke. And I got to tell you, it wouldn't be complete without a Julia Child impression. He was wowing me with those earlier.
Julia, a little fish stew here.
Fish stew is what's on the menu. It's called bouillabaisse. And how do we get things started here?
Well, I'm going to ask you to julienne some onions that we have over there.
Okay.
And that means to cut them long so that they're long, thin strips.
Okay.
And I've already julienned a little bit of our fennel bulb.
Mm-hmm.
And now I'm going to add just a touch of olive oil to our pot over here. And we'll turn the heat up on this a little bit. And what we're gonna do is start by, they call it sweating the garlic.
Mm-hmm.
So we don't wanna get it that brown burned garlic flavor. We just wanna get it softened up a little bit because with the broth, all of these vegetables are gonna soften. So we're gonna take the fennel and we're gonna put that in.
Mm-hmm.
And now you can put the julienne onions in.
Yeah.
And we're just going to let these go for a few minutes, and we just want to get it soft, so it's still a little toothsome when we have it,
mm-hmm.
but we don't want to get it so...
You don't want it so crunchy.
We don't want it crunchy, and we don't want it too brown.
Okay.
And then our fish selection today, and this is the great thing about bouillabaisse, is that you can put anything you want that comes out of the sea. What happens, this got started when the captains would come in,
mm-hmm.
and they would sell the very best of the fish, but they'd have all this extra catch.
So then they created just jump it in something.
Exactly. So for the crew, everybody would get. So we've got a little salmon today. We've got some sole. We've got some cod, some shrimp, some scallops. You could put a lobster in there if you wanted, or some crab.
Why not?
So it's. And what we're going to want to do today is just cut these into about 2-inch pieces. So like that would be a third. So you want about two ounces per person of each of the fish, so that you're going to end up with about 12 ounces of the fish in it.
Okay.
And like I say, it can be a whole host of flavors, and you can really take it in whatever direction you want. Now, we're not going to cook these yet. We're going to set these aside, because in a minute, once our broth is done, and I'm going
to
just, now that these vegetables are going, we're going to put a little broth in.
Okay, so the vegetables are going. We're going to get to the fish, like Bob mentioned, and that's all coming up later on in the show. Back to you.
We're back in the Rhode Show kitchen this morning. Chef Bob Burke is here from Pot of Four.
Mm-hmm.
You get bouillabaisse.
Bouillabaisse. And you know what I say to my kids when something strange is being served to them? Honey, you don't have to like it, but you do have to try it. So, Will, I know you love seafood, so I'm going to give you a big helping, right?
This is how I'm going to have it, by the
this
way.
This is how you're going to have
just
our
like
bouillabaisse?
This. Yeah.
All right?
Mm-hmm.
You don't like
remember, this is steel.
Well, I don't know why you gave him that, because you see how he's clenching it?
I noticed, like, right away, he's kind of
defensive. Back away, Bob, back away.
You don't like seafood?
No.
You are such a Rhode Islander. You are like the guy. You are the Rhode Show guy. And all this.
But you know what? I like necks. It. You
I told them that, by the way, after I got the gig.
There's plenty of us out there that do enjoy it. So, Bob, can you bring us up to go speed on what you've done here?
Well, as you can see now, we've simmered all of this. All right. Mm-hmm. What we're going to do now is take our ladle, all right, if we could turn that down. And we're going to ladle a little into the bowl. So go ahead. You do that. I don't want you to
just
get
just the broth
near
or everything.
Yeah, we're going to start with the broth, and just then we're going. Okay. Well, you can put everything in. It's okay. We'll organize it a little bit because we're going to want it to look pretty.
About how long is it sitting in here, though? Because when we left, you were just sweating.
It was like 8 minutes.
Onions in the finale.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah. I mean, how long were you gone? You weren't gone that long.
I don't know. Man, have I lost my mind? How long have I been here?
And now we're just going to spoon out.
Okay.
And let's bring out our. You could, go ahead. Go
like
ahead
a, no, and no, just. What?
Go ahead. Bring it all up.
Okay.
Go ahead. There we go. Isn't that beautiful? Look at the color. Isn't that beautiful? Doesn't that just make you want to eat that?
Nope.
It looks and smells
and the aroma.
Phenomenal.
But I'm taking your word for it.
So what we've got, some little necks. Oh, don't you love little necks?
Mm-hmm. You've added a lot more to this.
Our quahog, and we've got, and what's really nice about this, we added a little tomato.
All right.
So
tomato
some
I like.
Color. And shrimp. Do you like shrimp?
Nope.
Don't like that.
Look, you know what? There's always one problem, child.
We're not in the kitchen.
I mean, honest to God, I've never had this happen.
Surprise!
Surprise! Okay.
Now this is great. This is a good sized portion
too. Do you love the aroma? And now you can smell a little bit of that fennel that we cooked before, and the saffron is in there.
Okay.
And what's great about this dish is everybody's trying to stay a little slim in the summer.
Maybe that's my problem.
Is not what your problem is, but we don't have time. And what's really nice about this is that it's really low fat, other than just that little bit of olive oil, basically fish and vegetables, and the broth is really, really nice.
This
so it's not a heavy dish.
Quite a large portion here. Huh? About how many people will this feed?
We're going to share this.
Okay, but
in this
you're
is
making
two.
This at home. It's for two.
Yeah, absolutely.
This and portion size is for
what
two.
What we're going to do to finish it off is, do you like eggs?
Yeah, bread? I like eggs. Yeah.
Okay,
I'm
good.
Cool with that.
So this is a little aioli. It's a garlicky mayonnaise from
like
the south of
too?
France. So load that up onto our crouton, okay? And then we're going to garnish that right here.
Wow.
And this aioli is garlicky. It's delicious.
I'm
and
a fan of aioli.
What happens?
What is that?
What do I want you to do?
Oh, you want me to put more on there? Okay.
Come on.
You know what? If I had put more on.
All right. A generous. There we go.
Okay.
And now you put this right in here.
All right.
Okay. And what's going to happen is that by the time we get to the end of the dish, it's going to soak up a lot of the broth.
All right.
And you just use the aioli just to put a little, like your scallop here, you know, just a little on that.
Mm-hmm.
You ready? No? Here it comes again.
He's armed and
you don't have to like it.
That's
you just
a great
have to
idea,
try
though.
It. And but the flavor of the aioli with the seafood, the saffron, the garlic, everything is really, really nice. Now, accompany this from the south of France, these delicious rosé wines.
Okay.
Okay.
Nice.
I like rosé wine.
They're beautiful for summer.
You can drink.
And a glass of the rosé wine will be good with. So I'm going to let you off now since you like the rosé.
Beautiful. All right. This looks great. Thanks to Go Province for bringing in Chef Bob Burke today from Pot de Feu.
You still love me, right, Bob?
I do love you.
If you want to try this recipe, because I know all of you love seafood out there, head on over to the Roadshow page at WPRI.com.